Getting set for what should be nothing short of an epic battle. It's the pivotal Game 5 of the World Series between the Kansas City Royals and the San Francisco Giants. Hi again, everybody. Matt Vasgersian. Welcome to the World Series here on the show. With me are Eric Harris and Steve Lyons. And Steve, this is still anyone's series as we get ready for Game 5.
Well, and now you can see they're down 3.
Back now as we draw ever closer to first pitch, let's listen in to public address announcer Mike Carlucci. The guys will have much more to talk about as the night progresses, but first, let's take a look at the starting lineup for our visitors here, the Kansas City Royals, as Ned Yost has his guys lined up like this. And look there at the starting pitcher charged with facing these guys as his numbers are on your screen. Norichka Aoki will move towards the batter's box as we're just about set to get underway tonight. Now a ball lined toward right center. And that's a base hit.
Well, first pitch of the game, a lot of guys on the mound are thinking, all right, let's just get ahead here with the fastball. And he was having none of it at the plate. He drives this one for a solid single to start things out.
Alcides Escobar stands in as he looks at a called strike. And here's a fastball called for strike two.
Yeah, he has been patient up there, but now he's backed himself into a corner.
Barnes now the pitch. Fastball bounces up to the plate and it's taken for a ball.
Well, I think that fastball is just for show there. He's not trying to throw this for a strike.
Now a ground ball towards the hole. One there. On to Belt, and they turn to a double play. So bases are empty here with two gone, and that'll bring in the right-handed hitting Billy Butler. First offering to him stays upstairs. It's a ball and no strikes. And he won't bite at that one either. It's 2-0. Not very aggressive there as that's down the middle for strike one. Pitch on the way. Swing and a liner toward right center. And Butler's got himself a base hit. Josh Willingham will get his first cuts here with two gone now and a runner at first. Here's the first offering. And the 34-year-old veteran looks at a called strike. It's 0-1. Now a swing and a fly ball. And it in fact lands in the corner, foul. Good job of holding up on the low ball there, and it's 1-2.
Well, he watched that one all the way in, and it looked like he almost gave up on it. He's pretty lucky that wasn't called strike three.
1-2 pitch is swung on and lifted in the air out to center field. Number two is going to have room out there as he puts this away to retire the side. So a couple of hits here in the top half, but nothing comes of it. And now we'll see what the Giants can do. No score. Starting lineup for the host Giants looks like this. They'll match up against the guy you see there, the veteran right-hander James Shields.
Yeah.
So we're set to go for the home half of inning number one. Now a swing and a miss took something off that one, and it's strike one. The pitch. Hit on the ground towards first. He'll take it to the bag himself, and the leadoff man is gone here to start the home first. Angel Pagan will be the batter. Pitch runs in a little here as this is softly hit out towards short. Off balance throw, but he couldn't get enough on it, so it'll be scored as an infield single. Buster Posey digs in at the plate. On its tailor made to short, six. The second for one, and it's right over his head. And he'll make it to third, and there are runners at the corners with only one out. Pablo Sandoval will get his first shot at it here. Good changeup there to start him, but it drops a little low for ball one.
And you can see it. He's upset with himself out there at short. And he should be. He's a big leaguer. He'd like to get a ground ball here to get himself off the hook.
Changes up on him, but that's in the dirt for the ball. Two-oh on the way. Fouled back. Swing and a miss there, and it's 2-2.
Wow, what a good time to take something off of that pitch, and they had him fooled pretty good on that one.
Now the 2-2 pitch. Now a ground ball for Moustakas. This might be two. Infante for one. Over to Butler at first. A double play, and the inning is over. Giants come up empty in the first. We'll go to the second from San Francisco. No score on the show. Salvador Perez will lead things off here as it'll be 5, 6, and 7 due up to kick off the second. And the first pitch of the inning here misses down and in for a ball. It's 1-0. Here's a fastball that swung on and hit pretty well out to deep left field. And it's a fly out to start the second, one away. Omar Infante will dig in here. And this ball will be chopped foul. Now here it comes. And this misses the outside corner, so it's knotted up at 1-1. Right there at the belt, 1-2 now.
Nothing fancy. Three fastballs so far in this at-bat. He can go just about anywhere from here.
And 2-2. In the air to center. Number two is there, and he makes the catch for the out. And with two away now, let's take another look at our playoff brackets. And, of course, the question on everybody's mind, will we crown a champion here tonight? Mike Moustakas will stand in here, looking to keep the inning alive with two gone now in the top of the second. Here's a first-pitch slider that just tails out of the zone. It's ball one. No score here as we play inning number two. Now the 1-0 pitch. And he looks for the slider in there, 1-1. Just does manage to get a piece there as this is bounced foul. Grounded foul, still two strikes. And he just does manage to fight this one off as it's fouled away. Two out, nobody on. And it's to 2-2 now with the bases empty and two gone here in the inning.
Ooh, there's a tough one to take right there on a 1-2 pitch, especially after fighting off so many pitches leading up to that one.
Slider, but that's low as it's dug out by the catcher there. And this is hit well towards the hole. And that is into right field, a base hit. Lorenzo Cain will get his first cuts here with two gone now and a runner at first. Runner goes for second. Pitch inside. The throw is not in time as he just gets in ahead of the throw. Out of play off to the right. It's 1-1. And a breaking ball in the dirt that time for a ball. Called strike that time, and it's even at 2-2.
And sometimes if you don't get to a guy like this early, then you're never going to get to him. So you don't want to let this chance pass you by.
Hit hard on the ground to short. And the stolen base winds up as a moot point as the inning is over. Royals leave one. We'll go to the bottom of the second. No score. Number two will stand in for the first time here. He'll just fight this one off as it's chopped foul. Now here's the pitch. Swing and a miss, and he's in the hole 0-2 now. And they'll try and tempt him with one in the dirt, but he'll hold back here. It's 1-2.
Yeah, with the bases empty, that's the right spot for that 0-2 pitch. Make him see if he'll chase that slider.
And a good take there. Close, but it's 2-2. Now a ball hit high and deep out there to left center field. And that ball gets down out near the wall and should be extra bases. And he is in to second base with a leadoff double.
Well, this is the kind of at-bat that's going to give him a lot of confidence going forward. There's no doubt that he can hit left-handed pitching, and he's proven that throughout his time in the minor leagues. The question is, though, can he be productive against right-handers? That's an encouraging sign there.
The 1-0 now to Pence. 2-0 now. Lays off a fastball, but it's over for a strike. 2-1. And that misses off the plate and low, so it's 3-1 now. No one out with a runner at second. And this is down at the knees, but called a strike. Wow, it's 3-2 now.
That's a borderline strike right there. And I think that he had one step out of the batter's box headed towards first already.
And this one will be foul back in among the fans. Changeup had him fooled a bit as this is on the ground to third. And he's retired one away.
Well, we talk about it a lot. Ideally, this should be to the right side of the infield. Maybe you give him a break because he's such a good hitter and he is a run producer, but I'll bet if you ask him, he'll wish he had a different approach in that at bat.
And pitch is off the catcher's glove as it rolls away. And he's going to make it up to third here as he advances on the wild pitch.
Well, yeah, this is going to be a pitch in the dirt. And as a runner, it's hard sometimes to tell whether you should advance or not. But I think the catcher just lost sight of this thing just for a moment. And as soon as he reads that at second base, he's off for third.
And that's in there, 3-1.
Well, this pitching staff has done a pretty darn good job against him in this series.
And there's a called strike at the knees as he was hoping for a base on balls there, but it's a full count now, 3-2. Late decision to offer at the changeup as this is bounced to third. And they've got a man caught in the rundown. The tag, and they got him coming back to third. Brandon Crawford will get his first cuts here with two gone now and a runner at first. And he takes a cold strike, 0-1. From the stretch. Reaches down and hits this one on the ground to short. Throw on to second for the force, and the side is retired. So it's no runs on a hit, no errors, and a man left. We'll go now to the top of the third, and we are tied 0-0. James Shields ready to go here as we begin the third. Now a ball lined back over second, and that's in there, base hit. Norichka Aoki will dig in here. He singled to open up the ball game. Now a fastball to start things out. Didn't miss by a lot, but it's 1-0. Now this is on the ground to first. We'll see if they can get two. To Crawford for one. But they won't get two as he beats the relay to first. Alcides Escobar will dig in. 0-1 here in this one. Big hole on the right side. Here's the first pitch. And they pitch out here, but nothing's going on. Off-speed pitch in the dirt as he takes it for a ball.
Now after that first pitch pitch out, another ball here really puts you in the hole against a dangerous hitter.
Throw over to the bag and a dive, but he's back. Fastball, and he popped it up back into short right field. Number 12 takes charge out there, and he stays with it for the second out.
These are the ones that are hard to swallow. You've got the count in your favor. 2-0, you get a fastball right down the pipe, you wind up popping it straight up. And that's a missed opportunity, folks. Big time.
He's ready. Now the pitch. Now a fastball off the plate away. A ball and a strike. Pitch out, nothing doing. Swing and a grounder fouled, and that almost took the first base coach along with it. And a fastball swung on and missed, and his side is retired. One left for Kansas City. Home half of the third coming up. No score. Madison Bumgarner makes his way to the plate to get us started here in the bottom of inning number 3. In there, strike one. Yeah, this one's for Moustakas at third. No problem here, one away. Number 12 will be the batter, 0 for 1 here in the early going. Gets a piece of it as it's rolled foul to the left. Set up away with the changeup, but it's 1-1. And they'll come inside with this one, but the result's the same. It's to 2-1 now. Now here's a ball hit hard on the ground towards short. On to Butler in time, and there are two away. Angel Pagan will dig in. He singled his first time around. Don Shields jumps ahead here with a good fastball for strike one.
Yeah, he wasn't showing bunt there, but even with two outs, you can't let your guard down defensively.
And this is grounded foul off to the right past one-time big league outfielder Roberto Kelly in the first base coaching box. Changes up on him, but that's in the dirt for the ball. Willingham will head over for a look, but this will wind up a few rows back. Try to hold up in time, but to no avail as he went around and the inning is over. Nothing across here this half of the inning. We've played three here in game number five, and we are tied nothing nothing. Josh Willingham will stand in now to get us going here in the fourth. And they go right after him on the inside corner for strike one. Here it comes. And Willingham watches that one miss, a ball and a strike. One and two. This is swung on and missed, and this fourth inning will start the same way he ended the third, with a strikeout, and there's one away. Salvador Perez will try it again. He flew out his first time. And a changeup here, but that's taken low in the dirt for a ball. Fastball in there for a strike. 92 on the radar gun that time. Pitching has the upper hand early as we're scoreless in inning number four. Now a fastball that just misses here as the count moves to 2-1.
He's already up to 51 pitches now, and he's only lasted 3 1/3 so far.
Pitch runs in a little here as this is softly hit out towards short. On to first, and Bumgarner's rolling right through him here. Two away now. Omar Infante will dig in here. He flew out his first time around. And he catches the inside corner for a called strike. Nothing and one. Now the pitch. Off the plate. One ball, one strike. No runs, four hits. One error so far for Kansas City. And this looked to be on the outside corner, but it's called a ball anyway, 2-1.
We've seen that same pitch be called a strike more than once.
There's the cold strike he was looking for, 2-2 now. Now the pitch. 2-2 pitch pulled on the ground down to third. Up with it there is Sandoval. Throw in time, and the side is retired. KC down in order. On to the bottom of the fourth now, still with no score. Buster Posey will lead things off here in the home half of the fourth. And here's a called strike at the knees. Don't think he liked that one too much, but it's 0-1. Outside for a ball, 1-1. And he'll come back with one in the dirt as the count moves to 2-1 now. Too high that time, and it's 3-1.
Now this one sets up a big pitch because you don't want to lose that leadoff guy in a scoreless ballgame.
And that misses for ball four. It's a leadoff walk that starts the bottom of the fourth. Pablo Sandoval will step in. He's 0-1 thus far. Off-speed pitch in the dirt as he takes it for a ball.
Well, not really how you want to start the next guy after a walk. That pitch isn't even close.
Runners on the move for second. Pitch swung on and missed the throw. Not in time as he steals second. And this is fouled back and out of play. Posey with his lead. Here's the pitch. Off the plate that time and a little high. It's even at 2-2. Full count now. 3-2. A runner at second. Nobody out. And that swung on and fouled straight back. Good lead there at second. Here's the pitch. And a little battle brewing here as he fights off the two-strike pitch and chops it foul. Now here's a swing and a ball hit well out there toward right center. And they're going to hit the board first tonight as this ball's down for extra bases. And the run will score as the Giants stake themselves to an early 1-0 lead.
Well, there's one way to get our first run of the game across. Good hustle there on the RBI triple, and they're in good shape to possibly make it 2-0 with another base hit.
Number two will stand in here. He doubled his first time around. First pitch coming. And this one gets away. That could be a run. It is. And a pitch in the dirt as he lays off. It's 1-1. Fouled back. And the pitch. To two balls and two strikes now. Base is empty here with nobody out. And he swings and hits this ball high in the air and deep to left center field. And they'll have to chase it down out around the 382 sign. And they'll keep it going here as he's in with a double.
Now you see the pitching coach out for a word. And this is for no other reason than to let the guy catch his breath out there. They'll maybe give him a little pep talk and plant a positive seed in his mind.
Good leadoff, his second there. Now the pitch. Hunter Pence is in for his second plate appearance as he looks at a ball. It's 1-0.
Oh, he wanted that one. Probably should have got it, too.
Changes up on him, but that's in the dirt for the ball.
And just watching him grimace as he gets the ball back, you can tell this lack of command starting to bug him out there.
Now a fastball swung on and hit pretty well out to deep left field. And this will find the seats in left for a home run. So a two-run home run off the bat of Hunter Pence. His first homer here in the series. And the Giants have opened up their lead and now 4-0. Brandon Belt will stand in. He reached on a fielder's choice his first time. And there's a strike right down the heart of the plate, 0-1. Four runs here in this half inning. And that misses 1-1.
And if he wants to turn things around, that's a pitch that he's going to need to start locating better.
Swinging a ball line down in the left field corner. But this is going to get foul. And now a pitch on the way. And a changeup swung on and missed for the first out. So the base is empty here with one away. And stepping in, the slick fielding shortstop, Brandon Crawford. In there, 0-1. That's over, but low, it's a ball and a strike. Looking to drop one down, but he can't make contact, 1-2. And with that last pitch, Shields up to 68 so far. Here's the pitch. And he'll try to get him fishing there, but he won't offer in dirt, and it's back to even at 2-2. Got him.
That third inning wasn't too kind to him, but he's been able to put it behind him, and he's on his way to a nice 1-2-3 here in the bottom of the fourth.
Madison Bumgarner stands in as he looks at ball one here. Changeup had him fooled a bit as this is on the ground to third. On to first, and it's in time as they're finally able to retire him. So it's four runs on three hits, including the home run. No errors and no one left. On to the top of inning number five we go. San Francisco leads this one 4-0. Mike Moustakas will make his way towards the box to lead off the fifth. And this is hit down the right field line, but it's going to get out of play for strike one. Awfully close with the slider there, but it's 1-1. Now here's the pitch. Swing and a ball hit hard on the ground towards second. And the fifth inning will start with a ground out, one away.
Now after the four-run inning, we'll get to see if he approaches things any differently now that he's working with the lead. You know, you figure the approach will be similar, but that's a good job anyway of getting the first out here.
On to first, and very quickly, two are gone in the home fifth. Alex Gordon has grabbed a bat now and moved into the on-deck circle, so he'll hit in the place of the pitcher, Shields. And here's a fastball called for strike one. Good hard slider there, but it runs away. It's a ball and a strike. One and two now as that's in there at the knees.
He's closing in on putting up yet another zero.
Swing and a high pop-up toward the stands behind third. And Crawford will make the play, and the inning is over. So a strong start on the mound as he's blanking through the first five. Last half of the fifth coming up. Giants out in front here, 4-0. Wade Davis is going to take over here in inning number five, as it's going to be up to their bullpen to try and keep them in the game here. Number 12 will dig in for the third time now. He started the evening 0-for-2 so far. Infante now at second. And a high throw here, but not much trouble for Butler as he's able to make the play. Angel Pagan will stand in now. He singled and struck out in two trips. And he holds up here, but the pitch is a cold strike anyway. One out, nobody on. A big uppercut there as he popped this straight up. And I mean way up there on the left side of the infield. And Moustakas has this one for out number two.
And this is music to a manager's ears here. After he watched his club give up four runs in an inning ago, this guy's come in and gotten two quick outs to start the next inning.
This is hit sharply to the left side. And that'll get down for a two-out single. Oh, and the throw back in is a wild one. Fortunately, however, the third baseman's able to run it down, so there's going to be no advance. Wow. Pablo Sandoval will stand in. He tripled home a run his last time. They set the target in, and this finds the inside corner for strike one.
Maybe they'll pitch to him after all.
Come set, now the pitch. One strike pitch is a fastball high, and that evens things at one. Swing and a ball hit high, but not very far, out toward right center. And Aoki will put this one away to retire the side. One left for San Francisco. They lead it 4-0. Norichka Aoki will get things started here in the top of inning number six. And he gets ahead here with the fastball, strike one. Another fastball, another called strike, nothing in two now.
And I'll tell you, being in a two-strike hole is not the spot you want to be in against a guy like this.
Now a swing, and he just fouls this one away. Slider, good two-strike pitch, but it misses, one and two. Just does stay alive as this is fouled back. Swing and a miss on the slider, and that's out number one. Alcides Escobar will stand in. He flew out his last time up. And a fastball taken the other way, but this should be routine out there in right field. And quickly, two are gone now here in the visitors' half of the sixth.
And a lot of times, you know, you might say, four-run lead, we'll make that up. But I tell you, the way he's throwing the ball right now, they might be fortunate just to get one run off him.
Billy Butler is at the plate now as he looks at strike one. And there's a swing and a miss by Butler, and he's in the hole now, 0-2. This is taken there by Butler. It's a ball and two strikes.
Good high fastball. Maybe something to try and change the eye level there. Now, I might anticipate another slider down in the zone, maybe even in the dirt.
Throw to first will get him easily, and the side is retired. Royals go down 1-2-3. They're down 4-0. Number two will try it again. He's got a couple of doubles thus far. Now a fastball that couldn't quite find the zone. It's ball one. Up top, it's 2-0.
Yeah, he's looked at two close pitches. You get the feeling that this is the calm before the storm. I think he'll unload on this one if this thing is anywhere near the zone.
Oh, he took a big swing there as he lifts a high pop-up, drifting into foul territory at first. And Butler looks this one in for the first out. Hunter Pence will stand in. He's 1-for-2 so far. And that's high for a ball, 1-0. Now a swing, and he pops him up. Butler is right there, and that's out number two. Brandon Belt will dig in. Strikeout victim his last time. He'll start him with a breaking ball. Too low that time. It's ball one. 4 runs, 6 hits, and no errors on the Giant ledger to this point. Perhaps a little low there. It's 2-0. He couldn't pull that one back as he clearly broke the plane of the plate, and that'll be ruled a strike. This should end the inning as it's sent out to second. Taken by Infante. Throw on to Butler is in time, and the inning is over. So they go quietly here in this half inning. Game five moves to the seventh inning now. Giants on top, 4-0. Back here in San Francisco, the defending world champs out in front as we take a look there at the game summary for the first 6 innings of play. Josh Willingham is in to start things off here as he looks at a called strike. It's nothing and one. And he grooves the fastball there. This is hit high and deep out to straightaway center field. And hey, don't write these guys off just yet. It's a home run. A solo dinger for Josh Willingham. His third home run of this series. As they get on the board, it's 4-1 now. Salvador Perez will try it again. 0-for-2 with a fly out and a ground ball thus far. In tight here with the first pitch fastball, that's 1-0. 416 feet, the estimate on that last home run. In tight again, and it's to 2-0 now. Take sign must have been on there because that's right down the middle, strike one.
And this isn't the first guy that's been frozen by that pitch tonight. He's had a lot of guys shaking their heads so far.
Now a swing and a ground ball to third. Throw on to first, so a good comeback there as he gets the first out of the inning. Omar Infante will step in, a ground out victim his last time. Watches a fastball right there for strike one. Now here it comes. Crowds him a bit with a fastball there, and it's to 1-1. Changeup. Good pitch there. 1-2. Here's a fastball in on the fist, and that'll even things up at 2-2. Bases are empty, one man out. And this misses, so that'll fill the count at 3-2. And this is going to be a foul ball in amongst the spectators. Just did get a piece of that one, so he stays alive here. He took a big swing there as he lifts a high pop-up, drifting into foul territory at first. Belt is over now, and he's got it for route number two. Mike Moustakas will dig in here. One for two. He's singled and grounded out so far. And a first pitch slider is right there for strike one. Really using that slider to his advantage in this at-bat. It's 0-2.
He's come back strong since giving up the leadoff home run. Doesn't look like it's fazed him at all.
0-2 pitch is a curveball that misses 1-2. Slider, and that's hit on the ground towards second. Throw to first in plenty of time, and the side is retired. So it may be too little too late, but they're on the board here in the late going. Get up and stretch. Home half of the seventh coming up. It's the Giants 4 and the Royals 1. Brandon Crawford will step in now to lead off the home half of the seventh. And this is in the air now out to left. Therefore, it is Willingham, and there's one away now.
Pretty good work out of the bullpen, as you see there. He got called in much earlier than I'm sure he expected, but he's given him a real lift so far.
Madison Bumgarner comes on with one gone here as he looks at a called strike one. And this misses the outside corner, so it's knotted up at 1-1. The pitch. Fastball close, but he didn't get it. 2-1. And a big swing and a miss here. Two strikes.
This fastball is looking pretty lively right now.
We're in the seventh now. 4-1 our score to this point. And he tries to get him to reach for it, but it stays outside. 3-2.
Boy, you have got to make this guy swing the bat here on this next pitch. This is not the guy you want to lose.
And he lays off here. It's ball four. And that is really cause for concern as he's just walked the opposing pitcher. Number 12 will stride in, grounded out his last time through. In the air to left center. Kane calls off the left fielder as he takes charge for the second out.
These are the types of balls where you worry about collisions out there. This ball's hit fairly sharply, almost exactly between the two outfielders, but this should always be the center fielder's ball if he can get to it. So he calls for it and he puts it away.
He's ready now, the pitch. And this is high, a ball and a strike. On the ground toward Butler, but foul wide at first. Checked his swing there, and did he go? No, he did not, says the third base umpire. Ball two. The 2-2 coming. And they're working the outer half here, but that one's wide for ball three.
Well, that's an opportunity wasted on the mound there. All right, hitter's got to be defensive on 2-2, but that was so far outside, he didn't even have to worry about chasing.
Fastball here, but he's right on that thing as this is smoked into center field for a base hit. Long throw to third. And he is in there at third safely, so there are runners at the corners with two away. Buster Posey will dig in, one for two to this point in the ballgame. First pitch here misses wide, 1-0. Fastball, and that thing got up there at 95 miles an hour, a ball and a strike. And he'll look at a fastball here that's close, but it's 2-1 now. From the belt, the pitch, and he's fallen behind now, 3-1.
Now here, 3-1. You want to make sure you put this ball somewhere where he's not going to square it up. And if you walk him, no big deal. You just can't give up a three-run ball.
And he misses with it for ball four. So the bases will be loaded now with two away.
And this could really be trouble now because with runners on every base, they've got a chance to really break this thing wide open.
Pablo Sandoval will have a shot to really put this one out of reach now with the bases loaded. Breaking ball for a strike, 0-1.
Not a bad idea to take a look at that one there. Now that you've seen the curveball, you can start to get a better gauge on it. Get a feel for what it looks like coming out of the pitcher's hand.
Oh, and he turns on a fastball here and drives one into deep right center. And that ball is gone. It's grand salami time. So he will touch them all on the grand slam. His first homer so far in the series, as this is now a 7-run ball game. Number two will step in now. Couple of doubles in three trips for him. First pitch to him. And he couldn't hold back that time. They say he went around at strike one. Outside for a ball, 1-1.
And now, as a reliever, you've got to go out and give 100% and focus on the task at hand. And you can't let the emotion enter the equation, or it'll mess up your concentration and things will get even worse.
But one more look at the big blow in the inning for the Giants. Bye-bye, baby, a grand slam home run. We'll march on to the eighth. It is now 8-1. Lorenzo Cain will get us going now in the top half of the eighth. Swing and a miss, strike one. A little bit low that time, maybe outside as well. Grounded fouled off to the right side. To two balls and two strikes now. Now the pitch. And he gets around on the fastball here as this is hit fairly well out toward left field. And the eighth inning begins with a flyout, quickly one away.
Yeah, another good start to an inning for him here. He's really only made one bad pitch the entire game. That was the solo home run. Other than that, you can see there, not much to speak of at all.
And the third baseman will have a look at it, but this is back into the seats. And the pitch. That's over, but low. It's a ball and a strike. And this one's up around the eyes, 2-1. Fastball is looked at for strike two. Here's a ball hit foul down the third baseline, so they'll try it again. And this ball is lined into center field, and right off the bench he comes through. It's a base hit.
Not too many balls hit solidly tonight, just their sixth hit of the game, so now they need to figure out some way to string a few of these together.
Nerichka Aoki is next as he finds himself behind 0-1. Fastball right back to the mound to Crawford for one. Back to first, and a great stretch there may be the difference. It's a double play and the inning is over. Hunter Pence will start things out when we come back. Home half of the eighth straight ahead. San Francisco leads this one 8-1. Aaron Crow will come on now in a mop-up role as he'll just try and keep this deficit from growing any larger. And there is Hunter Pence. He'll lead things off as they look to perhaps build on an already sizable lead. First pitch fastball swung on and missed 0-1. And no offer that time from Pence as it evens the count at 1-1. Action in that KC pen now as a right-hander's begun to loosen up. And this is fought off at the plate as it's chopped foul. Here it comes. And this is cut on and missed by Pence as he set down on strikes for the first out. 8-1 our score as you look at our in-game line score. This one pretty much all over but the shouting. Brandon Belt will try again. 0-3 thus far. On the ground softly towards second. Taken by Infante. On to Butler in time, and there are two away. Brandon Crawford will stand in. He flew out his last time up. And a fastball is in there for strike one. Off the plate, one ball, one strike. And they'll come inside with this one, but the result's the same. It's to 2-1 now. Now here's the pitch. And here's a pitch taken by Crawford for a ball. 3-1.
Yeah, and you know what? You've got a better matchup on deck here with two outs. So on 3-1 now, they may not take any chances with this guy.
And that pitch misses for ball four. So the Giants have themselves a man aboard with two gone here. Madison Bumgarner will stand in here. 0-2 with a run scored so far. Now a fastball a bit too low here. It's ball one. Swing and a ball chop foul down the left side. A look at Crawford. Now the pitch. Tried to get that one airborne, but it's 1-2.
That thing's coming in there hot. 96 miles an hour.
Now a fastball as he just reared up and let that one fly, and the inning is over. So a good job for him there to bounce back after giving up four last time around. We're on to the ninth now in game number five. It's the Giants 8 and the Royals 1. Alcides Escobar will stand in, needing to get things started here in the top of the ninth. Ninth inning underway now as the first pitch is taken for a cold strike. Now the pitch. just off the outside corner. Not a friendly call there, and it's 1-1.
And that's getting bailed out at the plate.
And this one's in there. Maybe should have been strike three, but instead it's 1-2 now. And now pitch on the way. And a good take there. Close, but it's 2-2. He took a big swing there as he lifts a high pop-up, drifting into foul territory at first. Now a fly ball here, not hit all that well out toward Pence in right. And he's got it for out number one. Billy Butler will step in, a ground out victim his last time. Belt is there, and there are two men gone now.
And that's telling of how they've swung the bat. This has just been a punchless offense so far. And this pop-up is pretty indicative of their struggles.
Josh Willingham is in with two away as he takes a ball 1-0. And he fires in a strike this time to make it one ball and one strike. He took a big swing there as he lifts a high pop-up, drifting into foul territory at first. A crowd of over 39,000 on their feet. And this will be fouled away. Now another pitch is hit foul and headed for the seats, so the count will stay put at 1-2. Here he comes again, 1-2. And the fastball, easy to lay off that time, 2-2.
Well, I know the adrenaline can get to you sometimes, but when you start overthrowing your fastball like that, that's a bit of a red flag.
Now he swings and barely makes contact here as this is back toward the mound. Throw to first here is in time to record the final out, and the Giants are going to keep the dream alive. They take game five and now must win the next two on the road as this one is over.
Well, we talked about how they needed a good outing out of this guy, and he gave them that and even more, finishing off the complete game victory.
One more look at the final line score there to see the great pitching performance that led his guys to the victory. And guys, the Giants were buoyed tonight by a fine offensive performance turned in by this man, Pablo Sandoval. Strike a pose. He's our top player of the game.
Yeah, he delivered more than once with runners in scoring position. Finished with five RBIs, and that was more than enough to lead his guys to victory.
So that'll put a wrap on things here this evening. For Eric Harrow, Steve Lyons, and the gang, I'm Matt Vasgersian. This has been a presentation of MLB 13, The Show. For more, as always, head to theshownation.com. The Giants are victorious here, 8-1. Good night from San Francisco.